Hey, and welcome back, guys, to Hyrule Warriors! I'm ZeldaMaster, and in this episode, we're going to be starting off the Twilight Princess scenarios. We're going to be jumping into the land of Twilight here in Twilight Field, and we're going to be playing as Lana, because Lana's the only character we can play as. And the recommended weapon is the spear, so I'm going to be using that, and let's do this. Here we go, using the Deku Spear. I'm going to be using this one because it has the most attack and has a stars buff, so let's see how this goes.
Lana stepped through her portal and found a jarring sight. Wherever she looked, the kingdom was consumed by shadow. Though she knew of the Twilight Realm, she had never seen it firsthand. Lana's sorcery could not reveal who or what was causing the twilight to cover Hyrule so completely. She soon came upon a small village beset by monsters. Her mission to close the Gate of Souls would have to wait.
Okay, so this is definitely the one I'm most excited for because, yeah, Twilight Princess is actually my favorite game, so imagine playing in its world here. It's gonna be pretty darn exciting. Here we can see the Elden Bridge, just a bunch of the Twilight Fields, and we're gonna get started. Look at all of these Bulblins that are gonna attack us. We got the Walls of Twilight as well. It's cool that we're actually playing as a character we played as before, but with a different weapon, so it feels a lot different. Her combos are different. She has obviously a different move, so generally she feels like a different character. And that's what I love about the weapons. They completely change up the characters and everything, which is awesome. I noticed in Dynasty Warriors that's also a thing. You know, like I believe I played Dynasty Warriors 8 recently, and you know, there are characters with different weapons, but they're not like this. I don't know. I guess because the weapons are more iconic in this game. You know, we're using a freaking Deku like staff. It's so freaking cool. So it feels a lot different. But as you can see here, the Twilight Walls are literally blocking the path for most of the area. So we're going to have to like wait a bit until we can actually have access to that area. But let's go ahead and start things off by saving our allies. As you can see, there's something going on back there. Also, there's someone talking to us who needs help, but her name is Agatha. There we go. But we can't see who she is because she hasn't revealed her face, so we'll be there. Just hold on for a minute. We're going to head to Miss Agatha in a second. Obviously, if you played Twilight Princess, you know exactly who she is, and you know that she's a playable character. They revealed her before in trailers and screenshots and all of that, so yeah. But, oh, this is her Musou, by the way. She summons, like, a small great Deku tree that pops up and kills a bunch of enemies. And, yeah, I find it weird how, like, out of all of the characters they could have picked, they picked Agatha. Like, I guess they wanted certain characters from Twilight Princess, at least, like, one main good character from Twilight Princess. But, like, out of all the people, really, Agatha? It wasn't a bad pick. I mean, I like her as a character in this game, but, I don't know, I just felt like the freaking, you should have picked Chad. He would have been better, or whatever his name, the one with the glasses, I believe his name was Chad. It would have been hilarious if you did. It's like, instead of Agatha, you can play as him, and he just, like, used a book. Actually, then that would have been literally a ripoff off of Lana. I guess they would have had to come up with something unique, and he wasn't necessarily a bad pick, but this is the villager we gotta go ahead and save, and it's no ordinary villager. It's actually the princess of insects, so don't squish me. Look at that bug reference. You know, you squish bugs. Yeah, I don't squish bugs. I'm just saying you can, you know. So close one. Are you all right? Yes, and you might be. I'm Lana. I'm looking for the Gate of Souls. I just don't know where to look. Gate of Souls. Never seen one before. But I can take you right where you want to go. That makes no sense, Agatha. If you never seen one, okay. Huh. Would you know that? How would you do that? With the goddess butterfly, of course, I will guide you through the Twilight Realm. This little butterfly will help us out. I like how it's kind of like a reference to, I'm not sure if it's meant to be a reference, but it's kind of similar to like how Navi came and like flew away from us and both of the characters stared at her. This butterfly is like the same thing. She flies away and they're like, all right, let's get started. We got to do this. And by that, I meant like Impa and Sheik in Death Mountain and all of that. But let's go ahead and will on these guys, and then we'll be able to escort Agatha to her destination, as it tells us to do, which is up there. She's slowly heading up by herself. She's not afraid of anything, it seems. All right, that's cool. I guess we're gonna go ahead and go with her. Why not? We actually do have our Musou ready. Actually, I don't need to use it now, I think. But yeah, look at all these King Bulblins we're going to be killing left and right. That's what we're going to have to do to progress, because they're pretty much the generals for this location here. Now I'm going to need to take out my bow, because I see that Deku Bob up there. But Agatha is pretty good on her own. Not really, because, you know, she is your ally and she's going to suck when you're not with her. But when you do play as her, she's pretty good. She's actually a really unique character out of, like, the bunch. Like I said, though, all of them are, so. Yeah, but we're gonna go ahead and continue on so that don't let that allied base fall. Alright, I got it. We're gonna go ahead and quickly head back there. I'll leave Agatha to do what she wants just for a second while I make sure I completely destroy whatever red is heading towards our base, because I don't want to worry about that. I've been playing really risky in the past couple stages, but we're gonna chill down a bit and do things a lot slower and more steady, I guess. But look at that, man. This looks so cool. I can't wait until we make it to the Kakariko village part of the level. That is definitely the most outstanding part of this section of the map. You're gonna see when I do make it to it, but first have to head there. Let's just go ahead and kill this outpost captain, and then we'll head back to Agatha. If you want to make sure we have this part claimed, we'll make things easier so enemies don't spawn here. And I'm actually going to need my bomb for this, because there's something under here. Let's see what it is. It's nothing. All right, so that was a useless thing, but the door is locked. But that's no problem. I can handle this. So Agatha is going to somehow open up the way to inside those Twilight walls. So a pair of termites once taught me little door opening trick. What is wrong with you? Okay, I guess Bugs taught her some pretty slick moves. We're gonna go ahead and head towards her though right now and help her out. I think our base will be fine here. I'm hoping at least, but yeah, we have to quickly run back to them and continue on. Is this actually open? Did she do it? No, she did not. What's she talking about then? Is she literally standing out here? Oh no, we can walk right past it. Never mind. I thought it was literally blocked off, but no, we can make our way through. All right, so let's go ahead and use our Musou, because I don't want to deal with this guy. They're really annoying because they fly around and such, and you can't really hurt them when they are flying around. These enemies, you kind of like have to wait until they are at like a good point to attack them. There we go. All right, come on, deal damage. Oh, okay, well, he's the one hurting me at this point. Just go ahead and chuck a giant slingshot seed at him. A freaking like bullet. It's so cool. You're actually using like the fairy slingshot, like just a giant version of it, and she just chucks it straight at him like that. Bam! I wish it did more damage though. Maybe I should look into to upgrading my characters, especially since I'm playing as all of them randomly. I'm not gonna focus on just leveling up a certain character, so I might need to grind a bit with everybody, but we'll get into that soon. Go ahead and capture the outskirts keep, which we are currently in. So, you know, we're in the area we need to do so. And I'll just kill all of these bulblins. This is actually a really small, like, map. It's kind of sad because this is, like, one of the coolest areas within the game. You know, it is based off of Twilight Princess, but it's so small and not much of it references the lands of Hyrule. It's mainly like the Elden Province within Twilight Princess that we're like moving around. They should have literally called it Elden Province instead of just Twilight Lands, because it's not all of the Twilight Lands. Imagine if we actually get to like venture through Lake Hylia in Twilight Princess instead. That would have been amazing, but it makes sense why we couldn't, because we got the water part from Ocarina of Time. As well as the Death Mountain part. So yeah, this is a dark version of that enemy. Oh my god. And he's going to be pretty annoying. So I'm going to go ahead and use my Musou here. Hopefully, freaking Deku Tree can do some damage. I feel like it's strong. I don't know. It's not doing a lot, though. Did I actually kill him from that? No, I didn't. But nuke time! Bam! And nuke time again. Oh, no, there's photo bombs. Never mind. Hoping for a super bomb. Alright, let's go ahead and run around and hit him. 1, 2, 3, 4. And bam! We did it. while also killing 400 enemies. Not bad. All right, we're gonna go ahead and run towards this side, and we'll let Agatha progress towards you know, the north or whatever where she wants to go to. There's something I want to pick up. And it says we can literally head through any of these now, so that is pretty cool. But I want to make my way up here. I'm literally gonna ignore all of these enemies right now, which is a bad idea because they could gang up on me and really give me a beating. So that would suck. But if we make our way up here, where is the outpost captain? Are we gonna have to kill this guy to progress, or maybe I have to go from a different side? I don't know. I'm gonna run around here and see if this works out for me. Sadly, within these Twilight walls, we can't see what's going on within the map, so Agatha might be in danger. Hopefully the game lets me know if she is. If she has, I'll be sure to head back to her. But for now, I'm gonna do my own thing real quickly. Look at that. Oh, she summoned the small Deku, or the great Deku tree, like the one that appears when you're adult Link and gives you the whole story and whatnot. It's pretty cool. I kind of like that. I don't know. It's a cool reference as well. They sure did their research when working on this game. All right, so, I guess we are gonna have to go back, sadly. I was hoping we'd be able to continue from here. What's actually up here? Okay, well, yeah, no, we're blocked here. There's a Deku Baba hiding here, though, so I wanna go ahead and kill him. Gonna shoot him. Bam! You're out. I don't know what kind of thing you were blocking. You were just there in a random spot of the map, but I'll roll with it, I guess. Alright, let's keep going around and find Agatha. The X is telling us to head there, so I guess I'm just gonna go straight towards her. I'll kill this guy though for future reference, I guess, because it might be annoying later on when we come back to him. I don't know. It's most likely gonna get captured again. Even though we just captured that small point, the enemies are gonna overrun it. But here we are. We're on the other side, though, it seems. Can we make our way around? Yes, we can. The Bridge of Elden is actually right in front of us here. I'm rather curious where the Kakariko Gorge, like, is, or even Kakariko Village. Our mission is successful. Agatha has made it safely to her destination. Sweet! That's all we needed to do. Now a cutscene happens of something even more important. So you guys should have done this earlier, but it's Midna, another character, is here. My favorite The Legend of Zelda character. So let it go. That insect is important. Why? So it can fly around and spread poison on forces? What? Agatha has something else planned, it seems. Actually, the butterfly you see now is not a poisonous genus. This is a goddess butterfly. If you ask it kindly, it will guide you to anywhere you want to go. Isn't that nice? Guide me anywhere, huh? Hey, butterfly, take me to that ugly witch. Okay. Oh my, whatever should we do? Well, she just took our butterfly. Frickin' Midna. Why did she want to deal with that ugly witch? Guess we just have to fight it out. God dang it. Alright, so Midna's forces have appeared, and there are the yellow ones, and they are pretty strong. I'll tell you that much. So we're gonna have to be careful, because we can actually, like, die from them. I'm going to most likely heal up as soon as I kill this Darknut. If you want to make sure I'm safe. Actually, let's just go ahead and use our Musou here. Hopefully we'll break him out of that block, as well as capture this West Forest. And they are heading upwards. Towards the southeast part of the map. And oh, look at that, I did heal up. Nice. Alright, let's go ahead and move around again. We actually got full everything. I believe we picked up the item that heals like literally everything you have, which is awesome. But there's another one of these freaking Darknuts. Gotta beat him up. It's actually like a Darknut, which is weird how they are actually called that, because I believe in like another Let's Play I made a joke about that. Like freaking, imagine if there were Darknuts. And there are. So there you go. You just say the word dark twice. Alright, so there we go. Now that we captured it, we can see what's going on the map. And we'll be able to destroy pretty much everything that stands in our way. I don't know. Agatha is... comparing Agatha to Midna for characters that they add in this game, Midna makes a lot of sense. But still, like I said, Agatha is just kind of weird. I'm not hating, though. Are you serious? Sia's here, too? So we have, like, pretty much three forces fighting. We have ours, Midna's, and Sia's. So that's going to be great. But I'm going to go ahead and destroy everything here. So bye-bye. Bam. All right. Not bad. So, oh, crap. Yeah, the Dark Forces have interrupted and began attacking Midna's forces, which isn't bad. They can fight each other. Well, I also fight them. As long as you guys don't fight me, I'm happy. But obviously you will. As you can tell, I'm being destroyed by enemies here. I do want to make my way past the Bridge of Elden. I guess we'll just do that to see what lies behind there. We also got an arrow upgrade. I'm going to go ahead and use it so I can see how much damage this does. It did, like, nothing. All right. Unless it just wore out. But up ahead here is... we're going to figure out in just a second. All right, this place is blocked off. It's an area that normally would have taken us to the Hidden Village, and as well as like the Elden Caves within Twilight Princess and all of that. But in this game, it's just kind of like a dead end that we can't even head through yet because the gate is locked off. And our goal here is actually to slowly progress towards Sia's forces, the Dark Forces as well, as destroy all of Midna's while heading towards it. So I'm gonna do that while heading up here. Midna has this, and oh no, our outer keep is in danger of falling. I don't know if I should go back and help that out. I'm just gonna let it be. I'm gonna keep attacking and ignore anything else, I guess. I don't know. I do want to pick up the piece of heart though that is going to be collectible later on. We'll find it as soon as I make it to the section where it's actually located at. But let's see. Okay, maybe it's over here? I'm pretty sure here takes us to where that gate would lock us off at. But now it's open, so never mind. We can actually pick it up. Alright, let's go ahead and kill all of the enemies here, and we'll be able to pick up the piece of heart. I'm pretty sure this is the area where you pick it up for Lana. But the heart container is actually something we can't get yet until we get a certain item. It's kind of like the Skulltula that was in Death Mountain. I'm gonna have to come back later on. So even if this level was only playable as Lana and all of the collectibles were with Lana, we still have to come back and play it again as Lana when we get the item that we need to pick up the piece of heart. So that kind of sucks, but whatever. Hopefully I didn't miss out on the time where the golden Skulltula appeared, because I actually don't know if it appeared or not. It might have did, and like I didn't notice. But if that's the case, regardless, I'm gonna have to come back and play this stage, so it doesn't matter. But I might head back there after I claim this and pick up my heart, and then we'll help out our base. So there we go. Piece of heart might up here. Maybe this is the wrong area. Might be a little north from up here actually. So whatever. We got a good amount of kills. I'm gonna head down, help out our base, and then we'll quickly come back up and help out our team. So yeah, I guess I was wrong. I think it's a little up north from where we were at, and then we'll be able to continue on. But Midna does not seem happy. I just realized we don't even have 1,000 kills yet, and we're pretty far within this. And oh no, that has been claimed again. Dang it! That is not good. I guess we should go ahead and claim that. Sia has left the battlefield. Oh, okay. They were fighting each other, and now the central keep is open. I guess I'll go ahead and head there. Dark Forces are beginning to attack. Or beginning an attack. That's bad. Alright, look at that. Our knights are just running out of here. But we want to claim this. And the Twilight Realm is active. Holy crap, lots are going on. There's a crap ton of activities going on. But I'm just doing my thing. She's going around collecting things. All right, bye. I like how she actually like waves at the Deku tree before she goes away. She's like, all right, goodbye, or I'm done. Yeah, okay, well, go ahead and kill this guy. All right, Midna's forces battling with Hylian forces. Crap, come on. All right, there we go, we killed this guy. Let's kill one more, and now another one of these guys. These are the freaking, the boss keeps. The keep bosses, whatever you want to call them, which are harder to kill unless I land that attack on them. When I do, it's so much easier. There we go. We have recovered this. I think that should be our main objective, to get all of these claimed, because as you saw, it does some pretty good stuff. So victory conditions have changed, and that is defeat Midna to win. Alright, cool. Let's go ahead and kill more of her allies to get a bigger boost in our in our morale, I guess, as well as just claimness in general. But yeah, defeat Midna to get the goddess butterfly. That's actually what we have to get. See, it came for a bit and left. I don't care. We'll let her do her thing. But let's go ahead and avoid this Dark Knight's attack. I believe if we kill him, we'll be good. Oh my god, this guy's ridiculous. Like I said, I don't really like fighting Dark Nuts or Dark Nuts, any type of Dark Nuts, because they are so freaking tanky and I can't just get through their hard armor. There we go. Let's go ahead and dish out damage. Avoid him. There we go. We got a window to attack, and once again, there we go. It's a great choice. I have no... I have no choice to withdraw for now. I just need a few minutes. Okay, this is bad. Midna wants to retreat. But before we let her do that, we're going to go ahead and pick up the golden Skulltula that appears. We need to get that as soon as possible because it just appeared. And then we need to pick up the piece of heart and then stop Midna from retreating. So we're going to do that. But let's go ahead and see where the golden Skulltula is. The music is slowly getting quieter here. Is it up here? Oh, yes. Okay, there we go. We can see it from far away. Let's go ahead and hit this. And we have it. And now we need to pick up the piece of heart. Like I said, sadly, we cannot get the heart container because, it's unavailable until we get a certain item to actually locate it. But now I want to go ahead. So what? Where'd my power go? Is someone closing off patches of Twilight? Yes, we are doing that, actually. No, shutting down the source of Twilight makes her push over. Not bad. We actually have them all taken except one, and then the one she's at, which is really good. I kind of want to do this as soon as I can before Midna does anything, because our quest could end if she does end up retreating. Some of the scenarios change, actually. I don't think it will. I think Midna will stay until we defeat her. But regardless, I want to make my way up here, I believe. And right up into this keep, where it's filled with dark forces, we'll be able to claim it. So let's go ahead and do that. So all these sorcerers keep. Alright, there we go. Or claim sorcerers keep. Why are we gonna kill the sorcerers keep? That wouldn't make any sense. Just wouldn't. Alright. Come on. Die, you. There we go. The chest has appeared. Yay! Alright, we got our objective. We pretty much did it all at like the final stretch of the level as we, you know, plan on ending off the stage. But that's fine for me. Let's pick up this piece of heart and then make our way to Midna. But there you go. Not bad at all. Midna looks awesome in this game as well. I don't know. I think all of the... I really hope the next Zelda game that they make, like the actual Zelda game that isn't like a spin-off like this, is literally based off of these graphics. That would be pretty rad because... Yeah, this game has some pretty cool graphics. I don't know. I guess since it is the first Zelda game for the Wii U, we can see like finally what Nintendo could... put out, which is some really nice stuff, but at the same time, oh, look at that, it was claimed. Alright, I don't care, I'm gonna ignore it. Oh, crap, let's go ahead and head down before anything bad happens, because the keep down there in our allied base seems to be in trouble, so Midna has increased her power because, yeah, some of the Twilight forces have been reclaimed, which is bad, but alright, no, they're fine here. Alright, we're good. Alright, to Midna now. I don't care if these sections have been claimed. I should be reclaiming them to get her to drop morale and, you know, get weak and stuff. But I don't care. I think we got this on her own. She should be easy. She's been waiting for quite a bit. She's like, I'll retreat in a couple... I'll retreat in a couple minutes. But in reality... Oh, look. Oh, crap. Another one got claimed. Alright, we have to end this. We've been waiting too long. She's at half HP. She's not ready for us. So it's time to defeat her. There we go. She's gonna summon. I'm assuming she's gonna summon her pet. Yes, this is not Link, guys, because you know in Twilight Princess, Midna rode on the beast version of Link. This is actually just like a Twilight beast. So, Twilight Princess, Midna, in her imp form and all. It would be really cool if they had Midna in her actual form as a playable character. They might do that for a DLC. That would be so awesome. But yeah, look at that. She's stronger. I just realized she waved at Midna with her freaking Deku shield that just popped out of nowhere. I'm gonna go ahead and avoid her attacks. I know she has like a buff on her because she's stronger than she should be. I'm assuming because all of those Twilight keeps have been reclaimed, but I still think I can defeat her in the current state she's in. I'm not really that scared. I just need to wait for her to do some attacks, and then we're going to go ahead and try to wheel on her. There we go. Come on. All right. Next set of attacks will most likely kill her. So right now, to avoid this. Oh, crap. I got hit. But, come on. Min, attack me. Nice. All right. Nope. She doesn't want to go two ham right now. There we go. I think we are good. No, that did not give us a chance. Are you kidding me, dude? When are we going to get the chance to slowly deplete that weird hexagon that appears that will give us a chance to do a cool combo? Oh, there we go. Finally. And now, bye-bye. Wow, she had one hit left. There we go. Wasn't going to be that easy, it seems. But, the Hylian captain was getting overwhelmed, but we were able to complete it. Midna has been defeated. This area opened up, but we didn't get a chance to claim it. I focused on defeating Midna as soon as I can after obtaining the Piece of Heart and the gold Skulltula, and that does it. So yeah, oh, Miss Kitty, please, pretty please, can you give me back my friend? Fine, take the butterfly, but wait, you are not with the witch? So it comes out Midna wasn't evil, she's actually after the witch, aka Sia, you know, the one that appeared. We're not with her, so it seems like Midna is actually going to join our forces. So, should have led with that, and I still have some unfinished business. So, yay, we completed it. Now, it seems that Midna is going to help us out. Because, yeah, Midna's not evil, guys. She was never evil. Just seemed like it, because, you know, the way she came in and started attacking us. But now we can actually see her fanfare with the Deku Staff. Like I said before, that all of the fanfare victory dance thingies are different depending on the item the character is holding as well. It's really cool how that works. And with Lana's, you know, she was standing on a great Deku tree. So there we go. Get ourselves 10k rupees, which is good. Let's see what items we got. We got ourselves nothing new, but a couple upgradable items, more things we can use, and I wonder if this is, yep, I knew it. I know this piece of the illustration was going to be a part for Midna, because she's also on it. So now we can play as Midna, guys! And her weapon is the Cursed Shackle, which is, you know, for the Twilight Beast she rides. But yeah, there we go. Sadly, we did not unlock Agatha. Agatha is actually not unlockable within the story, but I'll get to that when the time comes. Anyways, that does it for this episode. We obtained the two things we could have got. We'll come back for the Heart Container some other time. But yeah, that does it for this episode of Hyrule Warriors. In the next episode, we're going to be taking on the Shadow King, aka the Palace of Twilight. So, thank you all so much for watching. I've been ZeldaMaster, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye!